feels so good to make it this far. And I didn't think I could take it so long. There were days I wanted to quit, and I said, surely this is it. But I held on. And I've watched as so-called friends turned and walked away. And it hurt so much, I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to night and nothing seems just right, Lord, I thank you for my life. For my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen, and all the moments I know, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus. And the moments I thought I'd fail, I was reminded of your nails. So I held on. And if I never live to see another day, there's nothing I would change or take away. I've had so many ups that they far outweigh my downs. Lord, I thank you for my life. For my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen. Oh, and for the moment, God, I know you kept me. Yeah, Lord, I just thank you for my life. I realize some I could have been one of the ones who lost my way. And there were times, Lord, I know I almost went crazy. Oh, but I'm still here, oh, with my life. So
Pastor Fleming took advantage on today. We thank God for this day, for this is the day that the Lord has made. We want to be glad and rejoice in it. Always say the Lord is good all the time. And all the time, God is good, not because of him, but in spite of him. Despite a moment like this, the Lord is still good. Our program is a service of celebration and praise. We come to celebrate and praise God for the life and the legacy of this our brother. Honoring the life of our beloved Aaron B. A.E. Bailey, Tuesday, March the 1st, 2022. 11 o'clock a.m. for Freedom Union Baptist Church. 3715 Westmoreland Drive, Dallas, Texas. Pastor Dr. Mac T. Fleming, Sr., officiator, your honor servant, Rev. E. Almarillo. We have had our procession at this time to call for a congregational hymn down by the riverside.
My head with all my cup running over.
But this is the last one I like. Surely goodness. Somebody say, surely goodness. And mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I can speak for Brother Bailey, and I want the world in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. And it say, but we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God and house not made with hands, eternal in the heaven. Therefore, we are always comforted, knowing that we are at home in the body, or we are absent from the Lord. We are comforted, I say, and willing, rather, to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord.
All those who love the Lord say amen.
Yeah.
All those who bow, all minds are with. Eternal God, our Father, give us every good and perfect gift. Lord, please now forgive us all for our sins. We thank you for the air that's in our stomach, the food that's in our stomach, the air that's in our lungs. Thank you for this moment right now. But most of all, we thank you for the time that you allowed us to spend here. Thank you for the time, the ups and the downs, Lord. Just thank you for the simply saying that you allowed him to be on this earth and roam with us.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Heavenly Father, for making us a cousin. Thank you, Heavenly Father. For me to come, it's good to say thank you. We just ask you today, Heavenly Father, if you're someone here, now I'm safely being saved, we ask you to use this time to save them this evening. We love you, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, church says.
I was so honored when Valerie asked me to sing. I was nervous, I must say. I'm right on the computer. Then I lose as often, but I want to say, as I thought about this song, I thought, wow, it had two titles. The second title is Peace. But if you really, really check out these lyrics, it's just a place of peace.
Yeah.
So, as you pray for this family, please pray for me. Because the people God gives us is not rich. And I just pray right now that you would pray for me. That I can be confident along with them. And they too can rest in peace. Because a love like this doesn't come along too often in my domain. This is why we're all here for you.
resolution in remembrance of Aaron Keith Whitaker Bailey. For none of us lived to himself, and no man died to himself. For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. Romans 14, 7 and 8. Whereas it is with fullness of heart and singleness of mind, we come together today to celebrate the life of our own Aaron Keith Whitaker Bailey. We pay tribute to a life well spent in Christ as the Freedom Missionary Baptist Church and Pastor Matthew Fleming Sr., though saddened by his death, rejoiced in knowing Brother Bailey has peacefully answered the Master's call. We thank God for placing a servant as he in our midst. We say to Sister Bailey, Tootie, Ariana, Patricia, and Dashon, his dear mother, Sister Patsy Bailey, siblings, family, and friends, to rest assured knowing when Brother Bailey goes before the judgment seat of Christ, he is secure in knowing when Brother Bailey goes before the seat. He is secure in knowing, as it is written in Ephesians 2, 8, and 9, for by grace are ye saved through faith. And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Whether as Brother Bailey knew his Heavenly Father and accepted him in his youth, he was a faithful member of Freedom and a dedicated worker in the security and mail corps ministries. Brother Bailey exhibited his love and dedication to his family and church in his strong work ethic, forged from his upbringing. He never missed a day at work. Brother Bailey made the best enchiladas and potato salad. It is rumored that Bailey knows the secret to making them. Brother Bailey liked having fun and hanging out with the family. Therefore, being known, some of our hardest places have taught us to trust God completely, to love unconditionally, and to rest in Him and His sovereign will. Be encouraged, family and friends, and know that Brother Bailey entered into another phase that brought him closer to eternal life with his Heavenly Father. For in Philippians 1 and 21, Jesus says, "For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." Be it further known, Freedom Missionary Baptist Church hereby dissolves the earthly membership of Brother Bailey as he has completed his spiritual journey on this side of heaven. He awaits that great getting up morning when the Savior returns for all of us. A copy of this resolution will be given to the family, and a copy will be kept in the archives of the church. Humbly submitted on this first day of March, in the year of our Lord, 2022. Sister Rhonda Moore, church clerk, Reverend Maxie Clemens, senior pastor, Deacon Kelly, hearing your reading. And in Philippians 1 and 21, let me correct that. It wasn't Jesus who said that, was Paul who said that. Amen.
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 Amen. We do honor the Lord on today, who's the head of our life. He's the beginning and he's the end. Yes. He's Alpha and he's Omega. Yes. To the pastor of this church and to all the clergy, to this bereaved family. March 1st, 2022 resolution, the Amalgamated Transit Union, Local 1338, 1111 Empire Central Place, Dallas, Texas, 75247. Ecclesiastes 3, 1 through 2 says, "To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted." August 2005 to February 2022. trust.
Yes.
17 years of accusation, some of them unjust. Yes. 17 years of hoping, searching for the way.
Yes.
17 years of dying, slowly, day by day.
Yes.
17 years of questions, we shall know at last. 17 years of mercy from the Lord of all. 17 years of waiting for his loving come. Time for dark is over. Let there be tears. God has been so liberal. Aaron gave dark 17 good years.
Everybody leave. Everybody leave. People. praise to God who's led my life. Honestly, Pastor Clemens, very young, and family and friends. My name is Don King Jr. I'm here talking on behalf of Aaron Whitaker, also known as Erickson Whitaker Bailey, who speak on behalf of Justin F. Kimball, 1982. Yeah. But if you are a graduate of Kimball High School, would you do me a favor, please stand. Okay, Aaron Bailey, also known as Aaron Whitaker. Aaron was a graduate of Justin F. Kimball, class of 1982. He transferred to Kimball High School in sophomore year. He came in from San Diego, California, talking that California talk. He was a member of the football and track teams. You would notice all the memories that I'm about to talk about of Aaron will have a lot in common. When a friend Daryl called me on last Monday and asked me to do this, I started to say no, I'm going to go ahead and do it. What am I going to say? So I got to think in and ask the Lord, you know, for some guidance. And he said, what I need what you should do is call on some of his other friends also and get their comments also. So I called on a lot of my friends, and these comments are coming from a lot of people who graduated in 1982. So Reginald Madon, he's a good friend. He said, Aaron was a good dude and a real dude. But he's an actual quote also. Crystal House, he was always nice and brought more food than asked to the class reunion. Tony Williams Allen, he had a gentle soul, very gentle soul. Arthur Allen, Aaron was a good teammate on the track team. He had great work ethics, and he was always very respectful and a good friend. Pam George, he was kind, truthful, supportive, pleasant, trustworthy, and he handled his business. Terry Mosley, Aaron always greeted me with kindness, could remember all the good times we had in school. He could remember things that we all totally forgot about. Tony Knight, Aaron was a humble and respectful guy. Devon Buck Fortson, he's here today. Aaron brought out the best in all of us. He made us much closer, better teammates, better husbands, better domino players. Most importantly, he wasn't afraid to let you know that he was a Christian. Yeah. Lisa Williams Beckett. Aaron Whitaker was a genuine, kind-hearted person, always smiling and didn't meet a stranger. Me, myself, A.B. and I became closer friends since high school. We played on the same football team, flag football team, same softball team. When I was a coach at T.W. Brown, Aaron was a volunteer coach, track coach, and football coach. We worked together here at Freedom Baptist on the security team, and when we were out there, we just shared all kinds of stories. He volunteered his time and resources at every football camp that I had for the community. He had bought food, resources, and everything. So, what I think of A.B., my word is love. Big heart. He was the ultimate teammate. He was positive, helpful, supportive. Aaron was reliable and committed. He showed Christ kind of love, sacrificial, other-centered, and enduring by investing his time and life in the others' well-being. This is a quote. You only go around once in this life. You can spend it looking for the negative, or like A.B. did, you can use God's gift of life as an opportunity for joy and grace. Justin F. Kimball's motto is, we always seek the best.
Yeah.
Aaron Bailey Whitaker's motto, he always seek the best. He will be greatly missed. So our deepest condolences and prayers are with Tootie, Ariana, Dele, Patrika, and in our baby.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
First, giving all honor and praise to God, who is certainly worthy of all of our praise.
Amen.
It is indeed an honor to have been asked to speak before you today. Only wish it could have been on better terms, but that being said, we're going to make the most of it.
Amen. I've been asked to speak on behalf of the Dallas Predators. We played flag football together for, 15, 16 years after we got out of high school and never came back to college. So if you are in the house, Predators, please stand.
Yeah.
I know I can't, but I just want you to know, those are the kind of things that Aaron did for me.
Yeah.
I'm going to miss that man. Let me tell you, I'm going to miss him. Miss him. I've had several breakdowns. I ain't ashamed to say it. Probably going to have some when I think about it.
Yeah.
But let me say this. Aaron, when I looked at the program, A-A-R-O. For me, amazing, admirable, respectful, obedient, and noble. Look those definitions up. Tell me if that's not it. Today, and family, if y'all need me, you know where to find me.
Amen.
How's everybody doing? First of all, we want to God, Pastor Lenny, Minister Russell, and everybody in attendance. But when I was first called to ask to speak about Brother Aaron and the security ministry and everything, I knew I would do it, but I didn't know how I felt about it. But I'm glad I said yes. Can I get everybody from security ministry to stand?
Amen, amen.
Well, we started out with Reverend Black back there. Well, he quickly slid down and Aaron became a
thief. Amen. Amen.
Anybody that knows Brother Aaron has been said he loves to keep you in check, and he always has a smile for you, and he just knew how to read people. Because whenever it looked like he was slacking, he'd come around and be like, you know, a quick, hot quick. Hey, did you see that brother pull up on the parking lot? Grab that something? Yeah, man, we saw him. What'd he look like? We have to let him know. We have to tell him what it looked like. So then on, you know, he kept us alert. He taught us to stay alert. And he just read people. If a stranger pulled up, he could first one off with their greetings just to see how what his headspace was like before he come around to everybody else. And that was just Aaron. He was serious, and we fellowshiped outside, and we talked about a lot of things amongst all of us. And he was just one nice, caring dude. Somebody that I love getting to know. And after church was over, he looked security, and Aaron became Uncle Aaron. Because he always had candy for the
kids. Yeah.
He started getting into trouble because some of the moms would come and say, hey, why can't you see a lot of these candy stuff? Then he slacked the candy stuff again and cracked the chicken. So he was a big part of this church family.
Yes,
and
amen.
And he's going to miss. And just want everybody to know we love you, we love Aaron, and we're here for
you. Amen.
Yeah. to anger and show appreciation show appreciation more and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special day might only last a while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you lived your dash? Just that little line sums up all of our lives. Like others before me and people last night, let me just share with you a few things that his co-workers, his work family, has shared with us. Within NORC, we have a system where we can share all kind of information amongst the employees. So when they heard that Eric had transitioned, people got on the internet. And first of all, everybody was shocked that the Lord called him home at such an early age. We wanted to spend more time with him because he was just that type of a person. Secondly, condolences and prayers to the baby family. But these are a few remarks I can call that employees said. Aaron was my boy. We talked all the time. He will be missed. Aaron was a stand-up guy. Rest in peace and soul. Aaron, you have your wings. I'm going to miss my dear friend. This is a hard pill to swallow, but God makes no mistakes. Thank you, Aaron, for making us laugh and always feeding us. You heard that over and over. You'll truly be missed until we meet again, my dear friend. Rest in power, my brother. Good news to know. Rest in power. Rest power is God. Rest power is Jesus. Rest in power. First of the family, rest in peace. My deepest condolences for his family and for every one of us in from our family. Brother A.B. showed me the ropes when I first started in East Dallas. He was a friend and a mentor. He will truly be his mentor, teacher. He never stopped teaching. Pray that God will give us, give his loved ones what they need at this time. And then the last one, I believe, that I'll share with this. My heart is heavy right now because Aaron and I became really cool over the years. We hired in together and worked the various locations on the same ship. We also had serious matches on the domino table. Pretty good. You would have thought that he put the dots on him the way he talked right. He was a humble soul and didn't mind helping someone that was in need. This was a Kimball night, so he said, fellow Kimball night alum, once a night, always a night, until we meet again at the round table. A.B., keep the dominoes shook. You're going to be missed. The condolences of the family to everyone you touched. And Dort's material management employee of the month. When I met his wife on the 20th, she said how proud he was of earning employee of the month. You know, he had been nominated several times. I'm surprised he hadn't been the employee of the month several times, but he said this was the first time I actually won the honor. I think that what he did to show us what a true employee of the month looks like. We did one other thing in materials management. We created a resolution also. This is the first time that we've ever created a resolution from the materials management department, which he worked in. So I'll pass that on to the family as well. Aaron Keith Bailey We will see you again in glory. But until that day, rest in peace and know that you are loved and missed. Thank you very much.
Well, my name is Mike Johnson. I am Aaron's oldest first nephew. So I didn't bust everybody's bubble, but I'm the one that's not how to be home. Be like me, just a bit. I feel like I was going to call him when I found out Ariana was going to U of H. But I said, I'll wait till I see him. And I need you. So I tell him, I'm going to be doing my books. I don't even know the address. She moved in the dorm. They don't have to shut it down. Fast forward to, 30 years later, and every time I see him, he's giving me some cash. I'm saying, I need you to do this. I need you to get this. And I'm giving you cash. So, every time I see him, he wants to go for a ride to the store. So we can be busy. We talk about a lot of y'all.
The chain will link again. delivery room, more nervous than I was, just saying, cousin, what do I do? What do I do? What do you need me to do? Being the reason why I was allowed to be back in the clubs in San Diego. Because you somehow convinced the dancers that you would be responsible for me. Memories of you always telling everyone how I mixed the entire club and how Kiki and I were the cousins that would flip tables up. I remember how I took you to your very first Puerto Rican festival, and every year you'd ask, when was the next? I remember you chasing breaking bread. I remember you chasing Chris and Red when they tried to tip the porta potty over while you were in it. Memories of us getting together and how you and Marcel would stay up late playing dominoes all night and making more food when it was only 5 to 10 of us there. Memories of us going to Big T and getting oils. And you would send me so much oils that the vendors named me the favorite cousin, as you told them I was the favorite cousin from Cali. Memories of you going to my friend's house that only spoke Spanish, and you were so surprised at how well my Spanish was that everywhere we went, you asked me to translate. I remember you were not a selfish person. You wanted success for everyone. No matter how big or small success a person had, Aaron supported them. You could have been selling CDs out of your trunk. But when Aaron told someone the story, you had a whole business of story. Any small success that you had, he wanted to build upon that success and let everyone know where your business was and where to go and buy items from. And if he had to get on the phone and call someone and tell them, he was going to make sure that he got on the phone and pinpointed you to where you can go and get those cities from. You made everyone know that you were the hype man for any small or large business. A lot of people describe you as being tightwad. I always said you were a selective spender, as you always make sure to catch a sale. Every year, Aaron would come to California for 4th of July. I ask that my family here in Dallas still continue that tradition, and every 4th of July we also try to get together as a family. Amen.
Blessings to the house. Protocol has already been established, and I'm going to ask for the pastor, ministers, just allow me to stand here because it's really hot up there. I don't want to stay in that door there. Little preacher in front of the mic. I'm going to just do what I can. I stand on behalf of the in-laws of the family. As my wife said on last night, I say on this evening, or this afternoon rather, that whenever I would engage Aaron, because I had not been in the family but maybe 4 years, going on 4 years now, he would always call me brother-in-law. He never called my name, he always said brother-in-law. And I always referred to him as brother-in-law. And for some people, they would say that that seems though you guys were not very close, but he had a way of saying it that gave it more impact than what one would normally get when you would say brother-in-law. It caused me to feel so important that he saw me as brother-in-law. And because I was new to the family, many things he was sharing with me that I might be able to understand the family. I think about our gatherings as a family, and I can always remember when Aaron would make those famous enchiladas. And I'm an enchilada connoisseur, and so I said, well, I'll try and see. I don't want to be the one to burst his bubble. But when Aaron made those enchiladas and I tasted them, I thought of the scripture that says, oh, taste this. he knew how to throw it down on some enchiladas, and then he would also have his famous fish and fries, and brother-in-law, how you like it? I said, man, you know what you do. I love how he was so giving. And then as I got to know him even more, I recognized, because now I grew up in a what they call professional environment on the job, so the only colors I had in relationship to clothing was gray, brown, and blue, navy blue, and black. And so when I got into the family, I had sort of retired from working on a job to that extent, and I noticed something about Aaron. He had a mean tennis shoe game. And I began to notice something about the family, but all the family had mean tennis shoe games. And I said, my goodness, I told my wife I'm going to have to go to the store and buy me some tennis shoes. I can't be running up here on this family with just one pair of tennis shoes. And every now and then at our church, we would have represent your favorite pro football team. And I could always count on Aaron for a nice jersey that I might be able to represent in. I know most people are Cowboy fans, but every now and then I just like to throw them on. And so he always was there for that. And I noticed also about Aaron that he was very protective of this family. I'm looking on my phone because I wrote this down because I didn't want to be up here too long. He was very protective of this family. And yet he had a humor about him. But his humor had an edge. His humor lets you know I'm laughing, but don't take this too far. Because he had a way about himself to let you know that he was able to handle up on whatever happened, and yet made you feel comfortable around him. So before I take my seat, I thought about when I was looking for jobs and whatnot, and reading over resumes that individuals would send in when I was on a job and responsible for various things of that sort. And I thought that there was, on a resume, you have an area where you would notate specifics with respect to your qualifications for the role. And I began to think about Aaron, and I said, what if Aaron were to present his resume of life to us? What would it look like? And most of you have already spoken to that already. I thought about words like supportive, friendly, reliable, sacrificial, pointed, resolute. Aaron was a lot of things to a lot of people. But I thank God that he gave me the opportunity to get to know Aaron, who I affectionately call brother-in-law. And he always let me know, brother-in-law, if you ever need me, need to know anything about the family, let me know. So I didn't get to meet some of the family members that came before my relationship with Michelle Mackey, now Morgan. Make sure I throw that in there. But for those that I did get a chance to get to meet, I really respect the legacy of the family. They are very close-knit family, and from what all I can tell, a very supportive family. And Aaron was someone that you could count on to be there, to just be a friend. And so I say to my brother-in-law and my friend, we'll miss you. Going to miss those enchiladas? Going to miss the fish fry? Just going to miss your friendship. But I thank God that I had the opportunity to meet you in the dash.
Let's see, man. I want to say this, that when you have states and countries, when the leader of that state or country cannot go, they send what they call an ambassador. And the ambassador, he represents that country. And he always speaks what the leader of that country tell them to speak.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So when I was asked to do this, I was just an ambassador. Amen. And then somebody asked, and so what we're going to change the program, we're going to add Abram's uncle, Reverend Tisby. He's coming. Amen. He's coming and he's going to have words. But there was another ambassador said that I need to remind him that he's not coming up here to preach. And so, so as an ambassador, I want to let him know that when he stands up and I sit down, and then when I stand up again, it's time for him to sit down. Amen. But I want to say this to the family, to the Billy Paul King. He said something that stayed with me. Three things he said. He said that when it comes to family and loved ones, we ought to love them how they live.
Yeah.
Lose them when they leave.
Yeah.
And then live in their legacy.
Yeah.
You love Abram while he's leaving.
Yeah.
Last time when you lose him, because
yeah.
he done left.
Yeah.
But guess what you can do? You can live in his legacy.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. So, Brother Simpson is coming. After he has finished, then we have a song by Lisa Lamb. And after she has finished that song, the pastor of the Freedom Baptist Church, he's coming to get word of encouragement, word of conviction, and word of salvation. Amen.
All right. I'm going to stand here if that's all right. I'm not a preacher, I'm a preacher.
Okay,
all right. So I'm going to be serious. Short, I'm going to be seated. I am Jim Longer and Cousin. But I want to say, by way of encouragement to the family, the Bible tells us, and most well, therefore, seeing that we are surrounded by such a great crowd, let us set aside all the weight and all the sin that believes. And let us run with patience the race that is set before.
All right.
Aaron has already run.
Yeah.
And he's finished his course.
Yeah.
But to know Aaron, I've heard a lot of good things about him. But to know him, you have to know his father. Now some of y'all knew his father. And his father was the glue that had us all stuck together here, the Kendricks and the Whitmers. His name was Lawrence Lee Whitaker. And he was short. He had the best sayings of anybody that you ever meet. And you have to know him to understand. But whenever he saw something, he heard something, and he really liked, he would say, back that up. And give me four more walks. And I just believe the other night, his father looked down and he saw the race his son was running. And I could hear all things, back that up, and give me four more balls. You never get enough of a good movie. Well, I want to say on behalf of Aaron, on behalf of his father, and our father, I believe on February 20th, our father looked out. Aaron was doing what he was supposed to do, he was at work. And I can hear the Lord saying, that's good enough. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. Come on up, and I'll make you rule over me. And I'm sure if Abram had to say it again, he would want all of our lives to live to where we all can look back and hear someone say, back that up and give me four more balls.
Miss Pat, Kim, Tanya, Coco, I love you guys. Thank you. Thankful for her, thankful for this family. Bailey, the last time I saw Bailey about 2.5 weeks ago, it was cold and people were rushing to the store to buy another odds and ends because it's been cold. And I rushed to the Kroger and went in there and all the baskets were gone. You know, when I signed, and then here comes the fella with this red t-shirt on. Red t-shirt on and red cap. I said, oh, that's Bailey. Give me this basket, man. You got 2 hours in a big old basket. Yeah, you come out into the big old basket with 2 hours. I think it was some chewing gum or something like that. Shame. That's the last time I saw him. And we laughed, and it was cold, but we laughed and talked, and he always had time to talk. He was a cool guy. And I thank God for allowing me to know him and to think that he would love me enough for me to be his pastor along with his family. And I'm so thankful for them. I can tell you the many times that I pray for you guys. And God bless you and God keep you. I'm not going to keep you very long today. We've had a good time. Amen. God has been good to us. God has been good to the family. Amen. I've been knowing them for many, many years. And before I was preaching, I knew their father, Reverend Pastor Mackey. They're just respectful guys. And I'm grateful to know them. And I pray that you continue to be together. Amen. Love one another. Take care of everyone. And whatever you're going to do for each other, you got to do it now. Can't wait till it's too late. You gotta, if you owe somebody some money, pay them now. If you owe somebody an apology, do it now. Whatever you need to do it now. Amen. Can we all say amen? God bless you. God keep you. Is our prayer. Let me stand. Father. Thank you. Job, the 28th chapter. 28th chapter of Job. The 10th verse. The 28th chapter of Job, 10th verse, says, he cutteth out rivers among the rocks, and his eye seeth every precious thing. He cutteth out rivers among the rocks, and his eye seeth every precious thing. Can we all say amen? And that's what I want to talk about, the eye of God. The eye of God. He cut out the rivers among the rocks, and his eye seeth every precious thing. Amen. The text referred to miners who labor beneath the earth.
All right.
Who digs in the dark.
All right.
Who cut rocks. Who tunnel through clay. Through the chambers of the earth.
All right.
And searches out its perfection.
All right.
They dig and dig until they find the vein that the silver runs in.
All right.
They take the time and dig and dig and labor until they find the stones that hide the gold.
I see.
They are miners.
I see.
They work where even the ravens or the eagles cannot see their labor.
I see.
They are working trying to find the sapphire and all the jewelry that's hidden in the darkness. They cut in the rocks and the miners labor to find that which is precious.
Right.
Where the average eye cannot see. Y'all go ahead before me. The miner is able to labor and dig until they find those precious gems. And if they, being human, if they being men, can find the gold that's here, if they can find the silver that's not seen with the natural eye. If they can go into dark parts of the earth and find things you would have never found on top of the earth. Because some things you have to labor. Some things are so precious you cannot find them on the surface. The fine stone of gold, fine stones of silver. The fact of the matter, the precious stone you wear today on your fingers and on your hand, that did not come from the surface. They had to dig deep into the ground to find those precious things.
All right.
So if they can find those precious things, how much more can the one who put it there be able to find it? I'm preaching to them, not necessarily have to find it, because he already knows where it is. He knows where it is because he put it there. And I'm trying to say something there for you, hey, that man here. We need to understand there are some precious things all around us. But we never find it because we don't have the time. You know, the energy to dig deep in one another. Some of us got gold on the inside of us. Some of us got silver, sapphire, all kind of precious gems on the inside. But our problem is we don't have enough time. And we don't have enough energy to dig into one another and see. What you do and who you are. I said we're more concerned what you do than who you are. It's not about, see, you can be a preacher, a good preacher, but a no good man.
The Bible says, while we were yet sinners. He saw the saint on the inside and gave him life for you and for me. While we were yet doing our thing, God saw the saints on the inside. Thankful for that. Not only did he see the saints on his side, he also sees the motive in the service. I wish I had somebody on the preaching line. I know that Sunday morning, but there ought to be some big bands in here. You see, all the things we look at is what they're doing, but we can't see the motive. But God not only sees the service, he also sees the moon. We saw Abram out there looking at cars and doing security, but what was his moon? And I found out that the moon is more important than the service. If the moon is right, God is praised.
Thank you.
God is able and he won't fail. God is able. God is able. God is able and he won't fail. Tell me who can make a mountain move out of my way? Who can make a miracle because of my faith? And when the doctor says no, who can still say yes? And when I'm in trouble, who's right there to help me pass every test? God is able. God is able. God is able. Tell me who can make a river out of a little stream? And who can tell the clouds to roll back so that the sun can look at me? And who can tell the wind to whistle through the trees? And when I'm in trouble, who's that same God that will come? God is able and he won't. No, God won't. He
won't. We therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth. The general resurrection of the last day, and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ. And whose second coming is glorious, majesty, judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed, and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty work whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Can we bow our heads for a moment? Father, in the name of Jesus, we come thanking you for this blessed privilege that is ours. Thank you for your goodness, your mercy. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for memories, our brother, this husband, this father, this friend. Thank you for all that you've done for us. Thank you for allowing us to have him for a while.
Yes.
We love you, O God, for the time we've had with him. Keep us now. In the strong name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
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 Listen.
Sorrows are no more.
we'll join hands together and we'll sing around the throne. Can hardly wait till the day I'll see you again.
Stay together, keep loving each other, stand in the gap, wherever there is a gap, stand in that gap. Value each other, appreciate each other. Everybody in this family are great people. I love you and be careful going back home.
Amen.
Any other announcements?